events worldwide on networks like HBO, ESPN, ESPN2, Fox, Showtime, USA Network, and others. He promoted world champions including Ricky Hatton, Acilino Freitas, and bouts involving Vinny Pazienza, Harold Graham, and Otis Gray. Pelullo is still active promoter international. Ladies and gentlemen, Art Pelullo.
Nito knows more about me than I do. I want to thank Nito and Joey and John and the Pennsylvania Boxing Hall of Fame. It's extremely important, and Russell knows this and the men in this business, to be recognized by the people, your peers, the people you do this with, the fighters, the trainers, the managers. It's the greatest sport in the world. I want to also thank two men who actually talked to the guys and put me to nominate me. It was Eric Botcher, who was one of my former matchmakers, and Mark Abrams. I had no idea that I was going to get this special honor. And I called John after he called me three times. I thought he wanted an ad, so I was going to call him back. And I said, what's going on? He says, Eric Botcher wrote us a letter, and Mark Abrams wanted to know, you know, put you on the ballot. So it's very great. I have been very fortunate and honored, and it's been a privilege that some of the men in the Boxing Hall of Fame I promoted. Hi, Jeff. Hi, Peter. I had the great honor of promoting Harry Yorty, who's getting in tonight. Great kid, tough guy, great fighter. Timmy Winstrom, Bernard Hopkins, Larry Holmes, and like Nino said, a lot of other guys, Nino said, a lot of other men that I really can't explain to you how much that I admire all the fighters. You don't have to win a world title. You have to have the courage to get in the ring and to challenge yourself to be great and to challenge your own fears and to challenge, can I do this? Can I be successful at this? And that's a very small breed of people. There's no other sport like it. There's no other gladiator sport like it. Nothing, it's not kickboxing, it's not the UFC. There's real skills to be a fighter. Whether you're a fighter who's a journeyman or starting to stay on top of the world like Corrales and Castillo, which I was very fortunate to be part of that fight. It was voted by the Boxing Writers of America, Fight of the Year, Fight of the Decade, and Fight of the Half Century. And it was just something that I will never ever do again. After the fight, I'll tell you a quick story. I know it's been a long night. I wind up at a bar with Bob Arum, who had Castillo, and I had Corrales and Kelly. And for some reason, we happened to go to the same bar. It wasn't on purpose. We spent the rest of the night trying to realize, what did we just witness? It was just unbelievable. I don't remember what John called me the other night when we were together, but it was the greatest fight that I have ever been involved in, and I've been involved with a lot of them. So I just want to say a few more things. 17 years ago, there was a young man who walked into my office. His name was Matt Rowley. He was doing an internship. I was getting free labor. He was in college. He hasn't left. He's smarter than me. And he is a young man that has the finger on the pulse, and he runs my day-to-day. And he runs everything that happens in our world. And then I have another person that's important to me, is my daughter, Stephanie. Stephanie runs all of our social media. She's my biggest fan. She makes sure I'm politically correct. I don't put anything out on Twitter or Instagram that, you know, it's not politically correct. She's very on top of things. And she's just the best that I have. And I have three grandsons with her and a granddaughter coming. And it's going to be a good year for the Pelullos. And then the last thing I want to say to you is everybody in this room knows that our families have to sacrifice. And my wife did a lot of that. My Barbie when we were young, things weren't that good. You know, we were hustling to make a living. And she never stopped me. She never complained. She never said, don't go on the road, don't go do this fight, don't do that. She never put it in my mind that I should have doubt. And we've been married 43 years. And I know all the men in this room know the saying. Yeah, I'm lucky, really. She's insane, but I'm lucky. There's a saying, and I want to make sure I get it right. A husband's work is from son to son, but a mother's work is never done. Did I get that right? Yeah, that's 100%. Thank you for having me. God bless everybody.